Good morning. Welcome to another exciting episode of DDOwiki Talk with your host T13, ShoeMaker, myself. Exciting time it is with update 30, 10th anniversary. So let's jump right in, I think. I think that's a good thing to do, is jump right in. Give everybody a chance to get caught up a little bit. All right, let's see here. Made the wrong one go away. Alrighty, let's get some people in chat there. Good morning, Mac. How's everybody doing this morning? I've been a little busy this morning myself, working on getting stuff ready for our show today on the wiki. Had to make a couple templates for what I am hoping to work on. you can see this big notice on the homepage here, anniversary event. Do not turn in your freebie token yet. More options will be available later with a later patch. See 10th anniversary freebie for details. Morning Z and Pador. Too many windows. Alright, so originally posted by Cordovan. I should probably look up the link to that, but I'm not gonna worry about it right now. Sword of Shadows is one of the ones that speculated to be on the updated list. 80s throwback mustache. Yep, I'm going the whole, what was his name? Magnum PI look. Morning Classic. So some of the stuff that I've been working on this morning. First thing that I, well, most recent thing I've worked on is, the party favor turn-in section. I didn't like the way that it looked. It was a big, gaudy, huge section of tables, so I collapsed them all, and I moved them to their own pages. Click on show, and it shows the table. So that way you don't have to look at them all, you just look at the one that you want. I might do a little bit more of adjustment here to make the table fill the whole width. I don't like this white space at the end. Cordovan link, awesome. So why don't we add that right in? Freebie. And the link for that is, so it's going to be quote author Cordovan big minor formatting cosmetic stuff that I like. Add a little note that's speculated to be added. Alright, so we got a quote down here from Cordovan, and that's from the forums. That's the post number, so I gotta put the P equals in there. Display equals zero. Alrighty. Actually, I don't like these all broken out like this. I like them condensed into single shorter chunks. If anything, maybe just move the quote down, but all right. Added. There it is. Link works right. Alrighty, so. I don't like the way that that's wrapping like that. Let me make another little edit to change the wrapping on that. What's that look like? Looks good, other than I want to get rid of the parentheses because I put it on its own line. There is no known list for that yet. So I've been trying to get Cordovan to let me know what's on it, but hasn't happened yet. So Sword of Shadow has been speculated to be on it, and 100k XP is going to be on it. I've gotten him to say that much. Let's see here. I've been spending a lot of time this week working on highlighting videos from the interviews. Trying to make a list of events as they happened. Before I forget, let's set today's prize. It's going to be 500 turbine points. I think we should have, oh, a dozen viewers today. And we're going to start with Mayquist, viewer. Then we had, let's see here, Pador, who I need to add to my list. We have, yeah, I have a few more to do. Z332. Classic Core. People already on the list. Good morning, Amaref. There we go, we're already up to five. Let me double check that list. We got Maquist, Pador, Z, Classic, and Amaref. Alrighty, so. Well, that's not good. Let's do this. Let me blow that up so you can see it a little bit better. There you go. Now you can see it a little bit better as well. On Friday, Cordovan did a 12-hour live stream at the office where he did, oh, I don't know, 20, 25, 30 interviews and a few different special things. He visited each server and either spawned some mobs or dropped some loot list items, at least until he lagged the servers out. I've been going through over the course of the weekend and highlighting each of the interviews so you can pick an interview that you want to watch. And then just click a link and watch it. The flimsy firewood is Cordovan's going to be working on uploading that, and I still have quite a few more interviews to highlight. Let me pick a short one. Bulwark was pretty short.
Tom Shibley, you are.
Tom Shibley?
Customer service manager.
Yeah, also known as Bulwark, director of customer service here at Turbine and for WB Games. I actually started at Turbine on the day.
So you got the interviews here?
With much more here and less great.
And then if you go to videos here, you can see the highlights here. The first highlight I did was Dr. Octothorpe. I did him a little bit out of order, but he's got 96 views, 89 for Freelorn. Produce of Ruin has 129 so far. Torque is up to 430. That's the guy that made the pit. Bulwark is 57. Vian is 98. Noah's up to 58. Nobob is up to 61. He's the guy that originally made hand wraps. He's why they're not working right. Although I think he pawned it off on somebody else, some technical person. Glenn has 61. Behind the scenes in Playday, which is a developer-only version of the Test Dojo, kind of, where they could do all kinds of spawning and things like that a little bit more easily. It's up to 74. It's a really good one to check out. Amanda's up to 50, who is their new QA intern. Silurin is the guy that gave us the individual volume sliders most recently for party members. He's up to 32. And then No Worries is up to 37. You can see I've been working on this for the last 3 days. 3 days ago, took a day off a day ago, and these ones were yesterday. Lots of good stuff. When they're all done being cropped and highlighted, I believe that Cordovan is going to make a playlist of them in order. And I'm also planning on putting up a forum thread with all of the links in order, matching this itinerary here of what happened. So that's what I've been working on over the course of the weekend. And the other thing that I wanted to get done today, my main objective for today's editing on the stream, is going to be working on the subpage. If you're unfamiliar with the old items, see the subpage or click on the unhide button for alternative ways to get these items to see if it's worth taking for you. That's not going to work. Okay, so I'm glad I noticed that now. I'm going to work on that. On the actual page, it actually works, but that'll be a little bit of a fix here. So let's, I built a template this morning to make this a little bit easier. So I'm going to take this right here, copy it, and I'm going to add that to the front of it. I'm going to add that to the front of it. If I scroll to the bottom and I hit templates used, you can see row here. Edit that real quick. And I'm just going to make this that's a minor edit there. It's just documentation. Alrighty, so now I can just copy and paste that in. So, as you can see, I've started revamping this a little bit with a template. It's just the name of the item, the minimum level, the adventure pack, the quest. Let me do this. So it's the name of the item, minimum level, the adventure pack that is required, if any, name of the quests, and then flagging, party, and drop rate are scales, 1 to 5. Flagging is 1 to 5 for how much work the flagging is, with 5 being the most. If it takes a lot of work to flag for something like Abbott does, you got to run The four flagging quests to get the sigil pieces to run the litany, and then you got to run litany four times, taking each of the optional paths before you can even run abbot. So I consider that to be a five. That's a lot of work, a lot of questing to even get flagged for the raid to be able to get the item. Party is a scale of 1 to 5 for how often I see groups or you see groups posted. I'm just basing on what I see on Kenneth mostly. If you see something different, then feel free to tell me what you think, how frequently you see parties on your server, and I will take all of the answers I get and average them together within reason, and we'll go with that. And then the drop rate of 1 to 5, if, for example, the Hellfire Crossbow. Every time you run that quest, Chronoscope, somebody gets a Hellfire Crossbow. It's always in the chest for somebody. So I consider that being a 5, being a very high drop rate. If it's something that is like almost never in the end chest, I don't know, maybe like in the Abbot, I almost never see the quiver. It's like one every 4 or 5 runs that I see a quiver. So I consider that to be a low drop rate with a 1. And then REQ is the requirements or details of obtaining the item. Are there any turn-ins? Are there any flagging quests, etc.? So you can see how this works with the first two items that I've already done. Quiver of Alacrity, I graded it as flagging 5. Party 2 and drop rate 1. So it takes a lot of work to flag. I do occasionally see an LFM for Abbot on Kenneth, and the drop rate's really low. So, and then the requirements are an average of 40 runs of Ascension Chamber. That's 2 20th completion lists. I've seen it drop on the first 20th list. I've seen people pull it in game before they hit a 20th list, and I've seen it not drop until the 100th, 100th run, the 5th 20th list. So I'm averaging it out about 40, because it's not always in the first list. It requires flagging by completing 4 runs, 1 run for each path of Litany of the Dead, which requires flagging by completing a sigil frame, which can most quickly be done by completing an average of 3 runs of each of Desecrated, Temple of Baal, Fleshmaker's Laboratory, Inferno of the Dam, and Ghost of Perdition. So that's how you get a Quiver of Alacrity. You can either run 3, 6, 12 quests to complete a sigil frame, run 4 runs of Litany, which gets us up to 16, and then up to, and then an average of 40 runs of Ascension Chamber, so 56 runs. So I would consider that a very rare item. And as you can see, using the template, putting in those values, it marks it as very hard. Hellfire Crossbow, on the other hand, flagging is a 1. It's very easy to flag. There is no flagging for the Chronoscope. I see Chronoscope runs about as often as I see Abbot. Occasionally I'll see one. They do show up. Sometimes I'll post one. The drop rate is 5 because it drops for multiple players in Razor Arms chests of every run of the Chronoscope. So that's a very easy item to get. All you have to do is run the raid. And you can actually solo Chronoscope on easy difficulties. So that one's a very easy to get. So let's start working on the next one. So let's copy the usage here. Copy. And the next item is Mantle of the World Shaper. All right, let's do this. Let's grab Rec, put that up in there. Let's get Ad Pack. Put that up in there. The admin and excavation. Put that in there. Minimum level. 5. And the name of the item. Mantle of the World Shaper. We no longer need that old list item. So now we just have to rate it. Flagging. There is no flagging for the chain. So there's no flagging, therefore flagging is easy. Party. I never see a party for that. It's mostly guild and private group runs. So I'm going to mark flagging as a 1. And then a drop rate. It is guaranteed every run, so drop rate is a 5. Let's see what that looks like. Mantle of the World Shaper. Very easy. Guaranteed end reward for completing the chain in order. Voice of the Master's difficulty is askew just because of how easy it is to mess up speaking to all the NPCs in red. Except that they fix that. It doesn't matter what order you talk to them in. As long as you talk to them all in the right order. Talking to them in the wrong order doesn't break anything. It just says, yeah, okay, talk to the next guy. So you can go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, and eventually you'll get it. There's no way to mess up the talking order. So, the next item. Voice of the Master. Let's get that one done. Oh, where's Mantle of the World Shaper? I didn't even look to see that one, how that one worked. Very easy, yes, good. Alright, so. Let's see here. So we got Voice of the Master. Guaranteed end reward. Delara's Tomb. Delara's Tomb. Minimum level 5. Alright, so this is going to be the same situation. It's going to be a 1 on flagging, 1 on party, 5 on drop rate. Belt of Brute Strength. Okay. Let's copy the requirements up there. This is from the Adventure Pack of the Restless Isles. It drops in the Titan Awakes. It is a min level 9. Belt of Brute Strength is the name of the item. Alright, so. Flagging. Flagging's pretty easy. There's 2 quests that you have to run. If you use the wiki, it's easy to look up how to flag. I'd say flagging is 2. I never see parties for this, so I'm going to mark that as a 1. Drop rate, I've never seen this item. Actually, in-game, I didn't even know it exists until this list came out. So I'm going to say the drop rate for it is a 1. Alright, do a show preview here. What's that give us? Very hard to achieve. Yep, I would say that's accurate. So let's save this, because I want to do it in chunks. Cost to acquire, that needs to be made into a non-sortable. That'll sort by pack. Unless I wanted to sort by quest. No, I like sorting by pack. Min level, that should be sort type number. I'll have to fix that. Although it looks like it's already doing it by number. So maybe I don't have to fix it. Alright, let's go back to edit view. I don't have to fix it, but it should be a number. And class equals unsortable. Okay. That'll make. I forgot to put in my pipe. There we go. So that's not sortable anymore, and that will make sure that it's sorted by number. Other browsers might handle it differently. All right, so let's. Copy this in again. Let's do the chatter ring ring. All right, so I'm guessing that it would drop on a 20th list. I want to do this one like I did Abbott. I want to change the formatting of the thing here, so it was requires an average of, so this is BR requires an average of 20 runs, which requires flagging of this by completing enter this and this. To get two single pieces that we'll have to assemble and repair for each subsequent run. Unfortunately, okay, so that works for me. And I'm actually going to copy this into here. And it's actually going to be the same for all of those things. Minimum level through drop rate. And the name is a chattering ring. Alright, so chattering ring is done. Alright, get that in there. Kondurik Delving Boots. Hey, Skunk. Skunk City of New York, huh? That gives us up to 6 attendees. Woohoo! It's pretty awesome. Alrighty. So, Skunk, I don't know if you've been watching, but we're working on updating our alternative list of how difficult it is to acquire the random various items that are going to be on the list of things that you can get. from your 10th anniversary token. And your input is requested. Copy this. Let's get this in here. Let's do the Kondoric Delving Boots. Min level 9. Add pack the Vault of Night. Quest the Vault of Night. This one requires flagging. Requires an average of, let's see here, Kondoric Delving Boots. I usually see that on a 20 lists. So I'll say 20 runs of there is going to be a giveaway. There is always a giveaway on Shoe Show of some kind. So let me add you to the list. EBOLAHPT. And Iskal San. Ooh, up to 8. Actually, let's save that list. Alright, so running the Vault of Night requires flagging by completing pre-raid of the Plane of Night, I think it is. Which requires flagging by completing Vaughn 1 through 4 Because it's so picky about case, I'm going to do a show preview. No, that's fine. It doesn't matter if you haven't played in months. You can still win 500 turbine points and then give it away if you want. Or I can re-roll if you win. The thing is, if I take you off the list, and there are only 11 other people, then there won't be enough people that will have showed up to not the Plane of Night. Vaughn 2 works, which is the prisoner. So apparently we need to add some links there anyway. So Vaughn 2 is the prisoner. Vaughn 1, 3, 4, and 5 need to be redirects. Vault of Night, we've got, let's see here. Oh, this is the quest, isn't it? This is the raid. Okay, so the Vault of Night is the pre-raid. Alright, so the Vault of Night's the pre-raid. Plane of Night is the raid. So let's fix that. So you've got to run 20 runs of the Plane of Night. It drops in the Plane of Night, not the Vault of Night. Pre-raid the Plane of Night. Vaughn 5 should be a redirect to that. I don't want to watch that. I can go away. Yeah, I always get them backwards. Complete the story arc, that's good. Thrask Arena is Vaughn 1. Come on. Mouse is acting up. No, I don't want to watch. Prisoner. Jungle of Khyber is Vaughn 3. Good morning, Titan. You're awake. I don't know. Should we let Titan in? Oh, I suppose we'll enter Titan. And he's viewee number 9, so he might actually win. He's not number 1. I need to update this program so I can have a little box, a checkbox for allow moderators. Make them easier to filter out next time. So, let's see here. Vaughn 1, Vaughn 3 is the Jungle of Khyber. Wait a minute, is that the prequest? No, that's Gateway to Khyber. Okay, so I'm fine there. Jungle of Khyber. Redirect, copy, tab, paste. No, I don't want to watch it. Vaughn 1, Vaughn 3, Gateway to Khyber. And Vaughn 4 is Haywire Foundry. There's that. Let's do a show preview here, see how that looks. Got an expression error here because I haven't put in values for the different things yet. I should actually fix the template for that. Although it should never give that, it should always have a default value. Not that it matters much, but let's see here. 6 times 1 times 1 divided by 3 runs. So it should always have. should always have a value. What's its value? If we inspect the thing there, we look at the TD. Oh, sort values aren't showing up. Interesting. My data sort values aren't showing up. I'll have to research that. I was almost certain it was data sort value. Data sort attribute. How about I go to nwp.org help sorting. Data sort value equals. Data sort value equals, so that's right. Wiki table sortable, data sort types, huh? Yes, I can certainly show you that. So if you go to DDOwiki.com and you scroll down a little bit, you get a what's new table here. This actually needs to be updated by me on my thing, but you can scroll across here and see everything from update one right on through. It's all here. It's got a little scroll bar. It's unusual, but I haven't implemented any other method yet because it's just the easiest way for me to do it. And you can go through and you can see what's happened in each update right up through to update 30, which is our current update. We have GNOME and Deep GNOME and Arcano Technician and Caneth Crafting Deconstructions fixed and Founders Commemorative Fountain Returns. There's also Less Osomium that it should probably be noted there. So, yep, it's all there. And then if you don't like this format, there's actually a table format that you can look at it all on one page. This is update 14 through 30. And then you can go to 2009 until 2012, the unlimited era. And there's update 13 through 2 there. And then you can go pre-2009 if you want the older stuff. And they list all of the modules there, all the old stuff. And actually, there's some stuff here that I have no idea what it is. But it's from way back when. So I'm wondering why my sorting's not working. I don't know, something I'll have to work on later. It's not that important at this point in time. Alright, so that's Kondurik Delving Boots. Let's go back to... It might be just a Chrome related thing. No changes, but it will purge it. Alright, so let's copy this. Make that go away. Let's do one more. Let's do the seven finger gloves. And I still have to put in difficulty values for the previous one. Level 9. Quest, the Titan Awakes, Ad Pack, the Restless Isles. Requirements, I'm just going to copy and paste from above. Delete all that. All right, so let's put in some values here. Flagging for the Vault of Night. How much work flagging is? Well, it's not no work. So I'll say 2 for flagging. Vaughn parties, I see them all the time. And the drop rate for the Kondurik Delving Boots is actually about average, if you ask me. I see it about half the time. Well, maybe a little bit less. So we'll go with that. I see some talk about gnomes in chat. So let's take a look at the seven finger gloves here. Flagging, what did I have for flagging on the other one? Flagging was a 2, not that hard. Party, I never ever see them. Drop rates, I've never seen the seven finger gloves drop. So I'd give it a low drop rate. All right, let's update that chunk. Now we're making progress. We're working down through the list. Filling it in. Looks good to me. Let me inspect element here. Now that I have saved it, maybe it's not a... Okay, so it is applying the data sort value. It just doesn't do it on show preview. So you can actually do an inspect and see what the value was. I might even put that as a tooltip. I don't know yet. Let's see here. Bump. All right, so that's good. I know a couple people that have them, but they don't drop very often at all. So, well, we're about a third of the way through the list here. Let's keep right on trucking. I'm actually going to change this help improve to be... not included. And I'm going to make it a WIP. This article is a work in progress. Ah, I like that better. All right, so put that in there. Scroll down here. Next item, Shining Crescents. Let's copy our template. Shining Crescents. All right, paste that in there. This is another Titan Awakes thing. It's a min level 10. So let me copy all of this stuff. So from the end of ML, I'm going to type in 10 and paste that. Now I just have to put the name of the item up in there, Shining Crescents. Okay. I think that's about the same. I'm trying to remember the runs that I've done in Titan, if I've seen that one. I know I've seen the Battle Coin often. I don't even remember what else drops in that. The thing I see the most often is the Battle Coin. So let's do tap threads. Tattered Tapestries is the quest. Ad pack is the Necropolis Part 4. Min level is 11. Item is Minos. Alright, so I don't need any more of this. Flagging for this. What was it? How much work for flagging? There is no work for flagging. There is no worry about party, and it always drops. So, we're going to do BR requires... or is it 25? I don't remember. Item, tap, S3, shred. Show preview. Yeah, I give them away in stacks for anybody that needs them. So they're not called that. Let's go to Tattered Tapestries, I guess. Shred of Tapestry. I'm actually going to move the 20 in there. Copy this. Paste it in there. Put an S on it. So turn in 20. It is 20. I think that's right. I don't want it to do that. I'll have to fix that. That should be a pipe. Come on. All right, so that one's done. Copy. So we got Chaos Blade, min level 12, ad pack Zawabi's Refuge. Is that the name of the ad pack? I had thought the ad pack was the Sands of Manchurium, or however you want to pronounce that. All right, so let's see here. Chaos Blade. What is required for flagging? Minchardium? I don't know. Charteron? Manectaron? Manectaron. Adventure pack is Demon Sands. See what that looks like. That works. Okay. Chaos Blade, that drops from Zawabi's Revenge, huh? What's the exact flagging for that? I don't remember. So you have to do the pre-raid, and then do those three. Oh. Okay, so it's a pre-raid. I just got thrown out of game. My background music went away. Oh noes. Let me get that back up real quick. I don't know if you guys can hear that static in my ear, but it's really annoying. It's how I know I get thrown out of game. Oh, it's 9 o'clock. It's coffee time. Let me get logged back in and finish this one up and save where we are at, and then I'll go take a break and get some coffee and some other good stuff. This is Kyber, I think. I got a couple dusty air elementals and some winter wolves. I got a whole bunch of good stuff to update the wiki with here. Actually, I don't know if this is going to work. Oh yeah, well, good. Little dusty air elemental chasing me. It's kind of cute. You must be able to see what I'm doing as I navigate my way back to the Hall of Heroes. Even though that's not the show that we're doing. That was a week ago Sunday. I want to go into the test dojo. Where's the door? Test dojo's there. I know it is. But there's no door. That's not nice. Tease us with a test dojo, but not give us a door. What's up with that? Alright, let's do this. Got Noah there, and Tolero, the Anniversary Djinn, and the Oracle of Wisdom. Hi, welcome. Love it. All right, so back to the wiki. Alrighty, let's get this done here. Pre-raid against the Demon Queen. Requires flagging by completing. Those three quests. Whiz King. And Offering of Blood. Chains of Flame. So Chamber of Ryan, Whiz King. Offering of Blood. Chains of Flame. Elder Jin, I guess. I don't know if he has a page. I don't think he does. Chains of Flame gives you Orb of the Jin. Offering Blood gives you the Blood Bowl. Although those aren't the actual names, I should run the quest to find out what the actual names are. Or, I know it's not just Phylactery, it's like Phylactery of Ram or something like that. Let me visit the actual quest pages and see if they give more details. Alright, so we are updating, or building, I should say, we're not even updating, we're building a table for the freebie items from the 10th anniversary, so that people can look at the table here and see how hard it's going to be for them to acquire the item without taking it as a freebie. That way they can choose what they want based on how hard it is to get the regular way. The hard-earned way. Alright, Chains of Flame. Bring back Orb of the Ifrit. Orb of the Jinn. An Offering of Blood. Blessed Blood Offering. I think that's what it's called. Although maybe not, I don't know. Chamber of Ram. The Phylactery of Ram. And actually, this should be moved into item space. Zawabi. Ah, that's his name. Okay, so it's Zawabi the Elder Djinn. Orb of the Djinn, Drow Blessed Blood, Blessed Blood Offering. And this should be moved into item space as well. Alrighty, show preview. Orb of the Djinn doesn't have a page. Because it needs to be moved into item space. Okie dokie. My order is a little bit backwards there. So what I need to do is I need to go like this. Move this down. Move this down. Move this down. Delete. Star. Delete. Star. Delete. Star. There, I think that'll look better. Oh yeah, it looks better to me. Alright, so let's give this some ratings before we take our party here, our break. So flagging, it's not the hardest. The hard part is if you throw away the Orb of the Djinn that you get from the quest giver instead of turning it in, if you're not thinking about it and you throw it away by accident, there's no way to go back to the quest giver and get another one without rerunning the quest. And that's, I've always found that to be a pain in the butt. You can avoid that by paying attention and reading all the dialogues and reading what it says on the wiki. Not everybody's going to do that. So, I'll give flagging a 3. It's kind of a middle of the road. Parties for ADQ. I don't ever see parties. Chaos Blade. I have seen that in the chest a couple times. Probably one of the more common things I see in a chest. I'm teetering between 3 and 4. Give it a 3, I guess. Let's see where that lands us. Lands us in very hard because of the party and the flagging. I don't think changing its ability would make the difference at all there. So I'm going to leave it at that. So let's save the page here. We're making some progress. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 items done. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25 to go. So we're a third of the way there. Feel free to... I'm going to continue working on this until it's done or until I have to go to work. Feel free to, at any point... I'll end up doing a lot of copying and pasting for a lot of this just to get much of this stuff done. Feel free to go in and I should be able to go a lot faster with copy and pasting once I get one instance done of each raid. Feel free to go in and make changes as you see fit. Once the this article is a work in progress is gone, I'll probably replace it with an update or help improve. Feel free to go in and make some changes. What are we at here? Oh, that's that. I don't need that. I want this. So we're up to 9 out of 12 attendees. We need 3 more people to show up. Get your guildies. And while we're waiting on that, I am going to take a 5-minute break, refill my coffee cup, use the men's room, and we'll be good to go. Back shortly. And I'm back. All right, so let's go back to edit here. Let's do some bulk updating real quick. All right, so stretch this out, make it bigger. What do we got here? Merilith Train. That's going to be copy, paste, ML12, Demon Sands, Zwabi's Revenge. It's going to be a duplicate of this, different item name. Merilith Chain, yeah, it's about the same drop rate too. Reaver's Fate. Do I have Reaver's Fate up here? That's, no, I don't have that pack in here yet. Okay. So let's do the Ascension Chamber one. Litany of the Dead. Min level 13. I actually see the Litany of the Dead drop. I actually got one. I see it drop more often than the other item. Bump that up just a hair. Reaver's Fate, Reaver's Fate, VOD, Hound. Excuse me. Staff of the Petitioner. That one actually drops even more often. It's a level 14. So let's copy this. I see that drop even more often. Untold Legends, Ascension Chamber, Unwavering Ardency, I see drop all the time. So let's do copy, paste, copy, paste. Well, no, it doesn't drop any more than the staff does. Okay, so that's that. I got a Vault of Night for Sword of Shadow. That needs to be moved. It's in the wrong place. It should be up at the level 10s. They're sorted by minimum level to begin with. So I'm in level 10. Shining Crescents, SW, so it'll probably go after that. Sword of Shadow. Min level 10. Vault of Night. I see that drop a lot compared to the other stuff. The base item, getting the shard and epic is hard, but the base item itself I see drop all the time. I see it drop much more than the delving boots, so I'm going to double that to a 4. Alright, so Gauntlets of Eternity, Reaver's Fate. Alright. Let's do Reaver's Fate. Ooh, Gauntlets of Eternity. Let's start with, yeah, Gauntlets of Eternity, Reaver's Fate. So we got this. We've got ML13. We've got... Ad pack. The ruins of Giant Hold quest. The Reaver's Fate. Flagging party drop rate requirements. All right, do a show preview real quick. So I can copy and paste the exact page name for that. The Reaver's Fate. Ruins of Giant Hold is what it's called. I would have put the in front of it and it would have annoyed the poop out of me. Ruins of Giant Hold. Requirements are going to be BR, an average of, let's see here, what is this, Gauntlets of Eternity? 20 runs, that sounds fine to me. Of the Reaver's Fate. Requires flagging by completing. It's got a pre-raid. Pre-raid is... Giant Hold Tour. Which requires flagging... by completing... Cabal 4-1, Madstone Crater, and Prison of the Plains. It's a Cabal 4-1, see? Good thing I didn't show preview on that. It would have annoyed the poop out of me. Madstone Crater, the Prison of the Plains. And Giant Hold Tor isn't really a pre-raid in the same sense that the other pre-raids are. It's more like a Litany of the Dead. So, let's see here. Do that. All right, so that looks good. Good morning, Edward. Let's add you to my list here. I like it when people that I have in here show up. I need to go through and add the other people to the database sometime. 10 out of 12. We need two more to give away 500 turbine points at the end of the show in half an hour. All right, so. Got a couple more Reaver's Fates here. Level 13s. So I can actually copy this part and paste that in there. Oops. Paste that in there. Paste that in there. And then copy this front part. Paste that there. Paste that there. Alright, so let's do those three all at once. Flagging. One is easy. I would say flagging for Reaver's Fate is pretty easy. Finding a party for Reaver's Fate Well, you could complete it with only five people. You could complete it with less. You could do it with one, two. You could do it with three or four people if you were really good and knew what you were doing. So finding three or four people, not that hard. I'll give it a three. The Ring of Lies has a fairly high drop rate. I see that one a lot. I see Madstone Boots maybe a two. And then I've seen Gauntlets of Eternity maybe a three. Feel free to pipe up and say something if you disagree with my assessments. And I would be happy to adjust them accordingly. All right, so those are those. Do we have any more Reaver's Fate in here? No. Oh, we do have another Vault of Night, though. All right, so let's get that Vault of Night. I'm going to copy this from the min level for the Vault of Night for the epic Helm of the Red Dragon. And then we're going to go... And then we're going to copy... Let's see here. This part. Drop rate. I rarely see the Helm of the Red Dragon, so I'll give that a 1 for a drop rate. Flagging doesn't change any. Getting a party doesn't change any. It's really easy to get a party for that. Right? 5 is easy. Yeah, okay. In general. You can solo Reaver's Fate. If you know how to fly over to the lever really quickly and fly back, you can actually pull the lever and then drop back down, kill the Reaver, run up, throw some crowd control down, get the puzzle done quickly, and you're done. So you could actually solo it. If you have good crowd control and you know what you're and you know how to fly. And I'll give you a hint about flying. Your swim skill, very important. Oh, there's always plenty of time, depending on how long it takes him to light the orbs. That's the part that takes the longest. Alright, so Thurn's Goggles. Let's see here. All of this above is done. Okay, so we're down to Thurn's Goggles now. Which is part of the Veil of Twilight pack. Alright, so I'm going to copy this. Put that in there. Put that in there. Grab the minimum level. Put that in there, and that in there. Add pack. Quest. And then I'm going to copy the rest from here. Throw that in there. Throw that in there. Flagging. One party. Okay, so flagging. One. There is no flagging for either one of those. Parties. I don't really see them anymore. Drop rate on the Tharn's Goggles, I'd give it about a three. Levix Defender, I'm going to have to give a four to. I see it all the time. ease of getting a group, probably a 2. I gave it a party of a 5. Okay, so I got it backwards. I meant to give it a 1 for a party. Flagging 1. Flagging's easy, getting a party's hard. Although I know a lot of people solo them, so in order to accommodate that, I'm going to give it a 2. Drop rate 3 and a 4. That looks about good. What do you have to do to get a Tharn's Goggle? There is no flagging. There is no turn-in. Complete the raid. Actually, I'm going to do it as requires less than 20 runs of less than or equal to usually requires Hound of Zoriat, a Vision of Destruction, one is fair for what? The difference between a 1 and 2 is going to be none. Because I know how the scaling is set up on the calculation for how difficult it is, it's not going to make any difference. It's going to be very hard no matter what I put in. Because anything with a 1 or a 5 or a 5 is very hard. Tome of Untold Legends, Vision of Destruction. Okay, so there's another VOD. Let's copy the VOD. VOD is Veil of Twilight. Let me make sure that I get the right wording for that. And case, it's case sensitive too, so make sure I get that right. Add pack. Alright, so copy. We have another VOD down here. Right here. Divine Vengeance. I don't care. Where was I? I can delete that. It's not minimum level 13. I wish I wouldn't get those notifications like that. It's kind of annoying. So let's see here, TP go giveaway, let's add let's see here, drop rate on Divine Vengeance, S3 is fine for that. Master Artificer. Caught in the web stuff. Okay, so we'll do caught in the web next because that's an easy copy and paste. Yep, TP code giveaway. That is correct. And you will be our 12th person that we need to roll for it. All right, so making progress. Let's do our caught in the web stuff next, so that'll be done. And then we'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We'll have 6 left to do after we do our caught in the web stuff. Yes, yes it is. Trying to you thinking about stealing my girlfriend, Titan? I'll have to tell Sienna on you. All right, so let's see here. Minimum level for these is all going to be 23. Adventure pack. What's the adventure pack for Caught in the Web? Is it Menace of the Underdark? Still gonna tell on you, Titan. Alright, so let's see here. Show preview, I want to see what that looks like, because we have 2 quests. I'd forgotten about that. Let's see here. Yeah, that throws things off. Still throws things off. So I might have to adjust the template for that. Alright, so let's adjust the template for that. Let's not automatically link quest. All right, so I can do that. And then I can take, copy this. Copy that in. Then I can take and copy this in. I'd still have an issue when I got back to the Air Dweller because there are 1, 2, 3, 4 quests. So that wouldn't work. Because I have a list of 4 quests there. So I can't auto-link it anyway at this point. What I can do is I can go back later and I can say if it doesn't have manual linking, then auto-link it. But that's going to take me a little bit of coding and I only have like 12 minutes left and I wanted to try to get as many of these updated to the template as possible. So let's see here. Flagging for caught in the web is going to be 5. Getting a party for caught in the web is going to be 2. Okay, so I do occasionally see parties for that. Not as rare as some of the other ones. At least on Caneth. Now, drop rates. Antipode. I don't see that one often. Balizard. Celester, I see about a 3. Cleaver, I see about a 4. Needle, I see about a 4. Pinion, I see about a 3. Seerith, I see about 4. Balizard, I'd say, is a 2. Yep, it's on my list of things to do, Titan. Oh, I know what I'll do. All right, so what I did is I added a parameter for item. And then I added a quests parameter with an S. So item, and then I can do 1, 2, 3 item, and then for quest, I can do quests pipe auto link and end auto link quests. That makes it quick and easy. That's the quick and dirty. Ah, did I now? 34. That is an awesome drop rate. Means you don't even have to run it to get that drop rate. All right, so let's take a look here. According to Cordovan Titan, the 100k XP instant redeemed has not been tested, so they do not know if bonuses will apply or not. So we'll just have to wait and see. So, abandoned excavation, huh? Hey, it's my friend's birthday. Let me get down here. Ore Raider's reward box. Awesome. Quest, caught in the web, or item, because it's not in the item namespace, I bet. But it should be. So we're gonna move it. Alrighty. So, 4 minutes left of our stream, and we have all but 1, 2, 3, 4, all but 4 items done. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 items left that we haven't touched, and 2 of them are Tome of Untold Legend. Though 3 of them are Tome of Untold Legend, so that should be a copy-paste. Should be pretty easy. We've got a Mind Sunder and Master Artificer, and then a multi-quest one. Alright, so let's do a quick sort. The undone ones are at the top, that's fine. So we got very easy, Hellfire, Sword of Shadow, Sword of Shadow, Mantle of the World Shaper, Minos, Ring of Lies, Kenduric Delving Boots is easy, 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 easy. Gauntlets are a normal difficulty. Madstone Boots are hard. Cleaver is hard, hard, hard. Chaos Blade, very hard. Those are all very hard to get. looking good. I like it. Quiver of Alacrity, very hard. So we can actually sort these by level and then sort by difficulty. Or sort by difficulty and then sort by level. Oh. It's upside down level. Flip that over. So difficulty is... Alright, so that's what it is. And it's doing... I don't know, it looks like it's doing an alphanumeric sort instead of a numeric sort on one of them. So I'll have to work on that. But we're making some progress. Let's get these Tome of Untold Legend ones set up. Start with a death nip. Minimum level is going to be 14. Quest is going to be Tome of Untold Legends. So it's going to be the same as the tatted tapestries for the ad pack. This part is going to be this. Woohoo, now the coffee's kicking in. Alright, so that's that. Now I got quest in there twice. Tome of an drop rate. Alright, so let's copy all of this. Twin blade. Skiver. So requirements, death nip. Item tome. Tome binding. It's going to be the same requirement for all of them. There's no flagging. There's no party, so it's going to be 1-5. It's going to be no party. no flagging, no party, and the drop rate, I'm going to mark that as a 4, because those are unbound as well and pretty easy to get. No comments, save it. 3 left to go, and it's 10 o'clock, so we're going to do our drawing. let's do our drawing and call it a stream. And I will finish up putting in some requirements for some of these, and tone binding doesn't go anywhere. It's probably not an item. There's probably not a redirect from the item page. None there either. Thank you. So there should be a page for it. It should redirect to Tome of Untold Legends. So let's do this. Paste, Control A. Redirect, Control A. No. Copy, Tab, Paste. Don't watch, save. And that should fix that. There we go. Alrighty. Looks good to me. Let's take a look at recent changes before we call it a stream. Nope, that was a 1-year gig. My year is up. All right, so what did we get done today? We did all those pages, no worries. No worries, says someone complained about the name Constant Criticism. The irony. So we made some redirects for Vaughn's. Deep Gnome Crew 121's been working on it. Deep Gnome Starter Gear. Ah, move Starter Gear out. Cool. Yes. Races TOC. D Llama. Yep. That's good. User creation log. Awesome. I did a little bit of work there. Move log, I moved a bunch of stuff. Did a bunch of work on that. Created a redirect for that. Looks like a good stream to me. Let's roll for our winner. Anybody else join us before I roll? Is anybody else in chat that wants a shot at winning 500 turbine points? Say hi in chat. If you're there and you want a chance of winning turbine points. Oh, while I wait to see if anybody else is there, give them a few minutes. Let's take a look at these. Free for VIPs, yes. Okay. D Llama, okay, yep, that's good. We still need icons for those though. Nobody else in chat. All right, so 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and the winner is Titan. I don't know. I don't know, Titan. What do you guys think? You think Titan should be allowed to have 500 turbine points? I mean, you know, he is a moderator. If he wants 500 turbine points, all he's got to do is ask, you know, Cordovan. What do you guys think? Think I should re-roll? Or let Titan have it? Grats, Titan. You're too nice, Ed. You guys are too nice. I guess Titan's our winner. Reroll to a gnome. I usually exclude moderators. So this is your lucky week, Titan. Make a note. You did win the lottery. Anyways, everybody have a good week. My schedule is like completely up in the air right now. My girlfriend is a little bit over 8 months pregnant. So at this point, it's like a anytime now thing. So I don't know if I'll be on Sunday or not. If I am on Sunday, I will be doing Drow Wizard. If I'm not, I'll see if I can find somebody else to entertain you. Maybe Titan can do a stream. Next Tuesday, same situation. If I'm home and available and not at the hospital, then I will be doing DDOwiki talk. Otherwise, it'll probably be a couple months before I'm back. Call it my my paternity leave. Blue Queen did. Had a nice boy. Snervablin, Send the code through Whisper. Nope. I'll send it to you in Slack. Everybody have a great week. Maybe I'll see you next week. If not, I'll see you in a couple months. Bye-bye.